Hello there. Welcome back to another data cleaning video. You know, there are 10 rules for good data. So here is an example of good clean data where all the 10 rules are properly followed. Now, there is another 11th rule which we didn't talk about earlier. And that rule is, if you have multiple pieces of clean data, then don't keep them separate. Here is an example. I have clean data, but I got 3 pieces of that data from 3 different places or 3 different products or departments or regions. So I kept them in 3 separate sheets or 3 separate files. That's a bad idea because sooner or later, you're going to require combined analysis. Same problem we have when we do reports on a monthly basis. We get a monthly file, we clean it up, we create monthly report, keep the file separate, repeat the process next month. You are going to require to compare across months, across quarters, years, and so on. So the 11th rule is, if related data is in good pieces, combine them in a single massive table. Power BI does not have row limit. Excel sheet has a limit of 1 million rows, but if you use Power Pivot, again, there is no upper limit. If you don't see the Power Pivot tab in Excel, install the add-in called Power Pivot. We are going to see 3 common scenarios. One is where there are multiple text or CSV files. Second is we have multiple Excel files. And the third is we have multiple sheets in a single Excel file. So let's start with CSV files. Here I have 12 CSV files in a folder. I'm going to go to Power BI, get data. Under file, you will see CSV. But this is good if there was a single CSV file. We have an entire folder containing a lot of files. So I choose folder, click connect, specify the folder, copy paste the path, and click OK. Now Power BI will go through the folder and show you all the available files. What we want to do is combine and transform. What is the prerequisite? All files should have the same structure. For example, here a single CSV file has 3 columns, and I have made sure that all the other 11 files have similar structure. If you're not sure, it is better to say combine and transform, so if there are any mistakes, we can correct them before importing. Power BI is now trying to detect which columns and what data types are there, so it needs a sample file. Because all our files have same structure, which file we choose as the sample file doesn't matter, so leave it as first file. Click OK. And now all the heavy lifting will be done by Power BI, and you will get clean data combined automatically across all files. In this demo, I'm showing you 12 files, but the method remains same even if there were 3000. Now, some of these files do have some blank cells, which is not a problem. I right click on one of the unwanted rows and specify filter does not equal. So it filters out the rows. Our data had 3 columns, but Power BI added an extra column called source, which basically is the file name. This is important if you want to analyze where the file came from. If it is not important to your analysis, you can just right click and remove it. In this case, I'm going to remove. So now that we have clean data, we can say close and apply and analyze the data further. The next thing we will do is to combine data from multiple Excel files. I have 3 Excel files here. The important requirement for this to work is each file must have that data in a table. Technically, we can import from sheets, but if you have seen the tables video, you will understand the benefit. Each file should have a table, and the name of each table must be the same. The process of importing and consolidating data is the same. We go to Power BI, get data, from folder, copy paste the path. As before, Power Query will show you the files. And this time again, we want to combine and transform. it needs to take a sample file, but in this case, it's a sheet or a table because Excel can contain multiple sheets and multiple tables. Do not choose the sheet. Make sure table 1 is selected or whatever the common name is. If the names don't match, this will not work properly. Click OK and the consolidation work will be done by Power Query and it will show you the combined data. As you know, our data had 4 columns, but it has also added one more column called source, which is basically the file name. If you don't need it, you can of course delete it. But generally, when you have a file name, it has some business meaning and you may want to use it for further analysis. If you don't want the .xlsx extension, you can right click and split the column and get rid of the extension. Split by delimiter, it is dot or period. Click OK. It splits into 2 columns. Second one, remove. And first one, if you want, you can give it a better name. Now you're ready to import the data by choosing close and apply. Now the data comes into Power BI and you can do further analytics. The third scenario is a little different. We have a situation where we have a single Excel file and it contains multiple sheets. Each sheet contains data and the data has to be a table. Obviously, in a single file, the table names have to be unique. So these 3 tables can have 3 different names. In this example, the tables have 4 or 5 columns, which is okay. We can remove the unwanted column, but whatever you want to import, the columns must be consistent. We go to Power BI. This time I choose Excel as the source. Choose the Excel file. Now the navigator will ask you which pieces of data do you want to pick up. I'm going to choose the 3 tables. Right now we have 3 tables, but the method remains the same even if you had many more tables. We want to clean up this data, so transform. At this stage, the data is not consolidated. Power Query Editor does open, but it shows you 3 different queries, each showing you data in each table. Now, first thing we want to do is remove the unwanted columns. So we don't want the month column. Remove. Check table 1. Remove the month column again. Table 2 is all good. The idea is to select one of the tables and append the other tables to it so that we get consolidated data. I'm going to append table 1 and table 2 to sales table. So I want only the sales table to be loaded in Power BI, not these 2 tables. So right click on the unwanted tables and remove this option. Do not load. Same thing for table 2. Do not enable load. Make sure for sales table, enable load is active. Now that we are done, we choose append queries. If there are only 2 tables, it's a simpler thing. You have to select the other table. If there are 3 or more tables, you have to select multiple tables, click on add and click OK. At this stage, remember, we had given some names to sheets. If these sheet names were something different, that means they had business data, you may want to analyze based on the sheet name as well, in which case you would want that to be an extra column. So I'm going to delete this append query right now. At this stage, we have 3 tables with the same columns. In order to retain the identity of each row, whether it came from sheet 1, 2 or 3, I'm going to do it by adding an extra column which actually contains the sheet name. As you saw here, the sheet names were P1, P2, P3. Adding a column is easy. Add column, custom column, give it a name. I'm going to call it product. This time there is no formula, we just type the name of the product. I'll repeat the process for table 1 and table 2. Now that the tables have the same columns, we repeat the append process. Home tab, append queries, 3 or more tables, select table 1, table 2, add and OK. Now we have clean data, which is consolidated across sheets. Choose close and apply. The data comes inside the data tab of Power BI. and now you can analyze it further. So that is how data from multiple files or multiple sheets can be consolidated using Power BI. Now remember, whatever I'm showing you in Power BI and Power Query is also available in Excel. If you have Excel 2016 onwards, these features are available in Data tab, Get and Transform section. If you have older version of Excel, you will have to install an add-in called Power Query, after which you will get a tab or a menu in which all these options are available. I'm going to create more videos like this on Excel as well as Power BI. But that is all for now in this video. See you soon. Thank you.